Buzzer TV presents vintage game shows on Amazon.
From Television City in Hollywood, it's Card Sharks. Here's the host of Card Sharks, Bob Eubanks.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Card Sharks. Glad you'd be with us today because this is the game where you can win a fortune on the turn of a single card. And to guarantee that our players get a fair deal, I want you to meet the two loveliest dealers in town, and here they are. Lacey Pemberton, Susanna Williams. Ladies, are you ready? Let's go deal the cards out right now, if you would, please. Susanna's going to deal the red cards to our returning champion, and Lacey will be dealing the blue cards on the lower level to our challenger. And while they're doing that, we're going to meet our card sharks, and here they come now.
Hi. Oh.
I honestly, Daryl, didn't know if we would see you today. I really didn't, because to refresh your memory, Daryl is expecting in less than a week.
Less than a week, Sunday.
Yes. Sunday.
Sunday.
I'm really worried about you. I just want you, we'll whip right through this game without any problem, so don't get too excited.
I promise not to jump too hard.
Now, yesterday, so far you've won $5,600 here on Card Sharks. Not bad.
Thank you.
And what are you going to do with that money?
Well, we already talked about the baby's room. We talked about the diapers. There is formula to get.
Sure.
And then there's, you know, extra bills and everything. I don't know, babysitters.
This is going to be a pampered baby, $5,600.
Yeah.
This is your first child, right?
My first child.
Well, you're our returning champion. Good luck to you. There's a guy standing right next to you that I know would like to become a champion, and his name is Tony. Hi, Tony.
Hi, Bob. My name is Tony Morgan, and I'm an LACC college student, and I also work in a major motion picture studio as a tour guide.
You're a tour guide?
Yeah.
You get grumpy with those people and they ask you all those questions?
Yes, yes, yes.
What do they say? What do they ask?
Where's the bathroom?
I don't want to know anymore. Okay. All right, you kept the deck of cards backstage. I know you did that. Now, the object of our game is to work your way across the board by predicting whether each card is going to be higher or lower than the preceding one. And as you can see, yesterday when we left off, we were right in the middle of a game, right in the middle of game number one of this match. And our champion, Daryl, you have two cards to turn over to win the game. And Tony, you have to do some catching up. That's all I can tell you about all of that. And if you remember yesterday that we had asked one high-low question. And remember, there's a maximum of four high-low questions per game. So we're going to start with our second high-low question in game number one of this match. Everybody remember all that? Good. Then let's start out today. Tony, the first question goes to you. Tony, we surveyed 100 people, and we asked them, should professional athletes be required to take tests that check for illegal drugs?
Ooh.
Now, Tony, you got to get as close as you can to the correct number. What do you think about this one?
How many people said
athletes should be required to take drug tests?
Well, with all the recent scandals that have been going on lately, a lot of people think that maybe they should, because sports shows are sometimes like, you know, heroes for kids. So, on the middle ground number, let's go for 56.
Do you think that tour guide people should be required to take tests for drugs?
It's funny you should mention that.
Or a game show host because of that. No. So you say 56 out of 100 should be required to take, said that the athlete should be required to take drug tests. Is that correct?
Mm-hmm.
All right. Daryl, do you think the actual number is going to be higher or lower?
Higher, because people just don't like drugs right now.
You know, if you're not taking them, why not take the test? You know, so
that's
you think
exactly
it's going to be higher?
It's got to be higher.
All right, if the answer is higher, you get the first crack at the cards. Otherwise, Tony will get a shot at the cards. Actual number of people who said that professional athletes should be required to take drug tests is 73. Yes, it was higher.
Okay.
All right. If you remember last time, you froze right there. That means you can change this base card if you want to. Change that card.
Yes, please.
Good for you. The 9 now becomes a 6, and you got to play it. What will it be?
I got to play it, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll go with the odds. Higher.
You're going to say higher than the 6. The card is a king. Yes, it is. Now, let me tell you something, Daryl. You can freeze right now and protect your position, or you can keep calling high-low cards down the line. But if you make a wrong call at any point, you lose your cards, you go back to your original base card, and Tony gets a shot at the cards.
I'm going to make a stab at it. Lower.
You're going to go lower than the king.
Right?
This is for the game, $100. Game number one of this match. If it's lower than the king, yes! Lower than the king. And Daryl, you win the game. You did it again, Chip. Add $100 to that total winnings. And we'll pause for these words and we'll come back with game number two in this match on Card Shark. We'll see you in just a moment. And welcome back to Card Sharks. Well, Daryl, our champion won game number one. You can add another $100 to that total. Remember, it's $100 when you win a game. And if you win two games, first player to win two games, then goes on to play the big money cards. And that's where the excitement really begins. So, Suzanne, if you'd please deal out new cards from the same deck, and we'll start game two right now with our high-low question. And this one goes to Daryl, our champion. Daryl, we surveyed 100 single women, and we asked them, have you ever gone on a date with a man that you knew was married? How many women said, why are you laughing? How many women said they have? Have you ever done that? Be honest with me.
I didn't know he was married.
Oh, you didn't know?
No. Truth. I didn't know he was married.
What happened to him?
I let him go after three dates when he told me he was married.
Oh, he told you three dates later?
Yeah.
All right. How many women said they have, though? They knew he was married.
Well, I hate to say it, but a lot of women are dating married men now. It's safe, it's comfortable, it's convenient, and I have to say the number's in there, but not a lot would admit it. I'd say 43. 43
safe,
out of 100.
Comfortable, and convenient. No kidding. 43 out of 100, you say, have done that. Tony, will the number be higher or lower than that?
Lower? Yeah.
All right.
I don't believe that. Lower. It's got to be lower.
What's your answer, Tony?
Lower.
Oh, I'm sorry. The actual number of single women who have gone on a date with a married man is 39. It was lower, but not much lower. Not much lower at all. Okay, Tony, the cards are yours, and here we go. Here's your base card. You ready? It's a 5.
Okay.
You can change it if you want to.
Higher.
You're going to keep that card?
Yeah, I'm going to keep it higher.
Right. Higher than the 5, the card's a 9. Freeze the play on.
Freeze
it right there. And that way, Daryl doesn't get to her cards, and maybe you'll be able to chance to change that base card if you win our next high-low question. And here is that question, by the way. Tony, it's for you. Tony, we surveyed 100 men. We asked them, if the FBI investigated your past, could they find something that might send you to jail? How many men said that the FBI could find something incriminating in their past? I mean, we're going to jail now.
I think a lot of guys, when they get investigated, they might think something might put them in jail. You know, everybody has a skeleton in their closet.
And you want to tell me about yours?
We don't have enough time.
Oh, I see.
So,
big closet.
Not really, Mom, okay? Going on.
Married women, huh?
I'm going to say a lot think, so let's make it 42. 42.
So you say that 42 men said that the FBI could find something incriminating in their past. 42 out of 100, Daryl?
I disagree. I think it's lower. I don't think a lot of men think that they've done anything illegal.
Yeah, I tend to agree with you.
Yeah.
Actual number of men who said that the FBI could find something that might send them to jail is 13. It was much lower. All right, Daryl, here we go. Game number two. This is your card. The base card is a 5. Change if you want to.
I'm going to change that card.
You're going to change that card?
Sure, I got the chance.
Okay. Tony kept his 5. You're going to change yours.
Oh.
It's now an 8. Whoa. Got to play. Higher or lower?
Got to play. Okay. Higher.
Higher than the 8.
Higher.
Here we go. No. Not higher than the 8.
You go.
And that means that Tony gets a free shot of the card.
Okay.
Tony, you're going to play
change
off the 9.
The card.
Can't change it. You got to go play with this one.
Oh, okay.
This is a free shot for you.
Lower.
Lower than the 9.
Lower.
Here we go. No, not lower than the 9. Nothing ventured, nothing lost, though, really. Okay, so we have a good close game going, and here we go. This is question number 3. Remember, a maximum of 4 questions in each game. Daryl, this is yours. We surveyed 100 people. We asked them, do you think it's wrong for a mother to breastfeed her baby in public? How apropos, my dear. How many people said that it's wrong?
Well, I think there are an awful lot of mothers out there who have to, and I don't think they think it's wrong. As long as it's discreet, I mean, covered, and well, heck. I think it's got to be a fairly low number that think it's wrong. So I'd say 32.
It makes me uncomfortable.
It does?
Yeah. It makes me very uncomfortable.
Yeah.
All right. Tony, she says 32 out of 100 people said it was wrong. It was wrong. You think the actual number's higher
or lower? I'm going to say higher.
Higher?
Yeah.
Does it bother you?
It's happened to me once or twice on a tour. It's embarrassing.
On the tour?
Yeah, right in front of your face.
Right before Jaws, huh?
You got it.
I see. Actual number of people who said that it's wrong for a mother to breastfeed her baby in public is 39. You're right. It was higher, Tony. Yeah. Now you can get rid of that 9.
Change it.
Change it. He says the 9 is now 4.
Higher.
Higher than the 4. Playing on. Here we go. It's a 6. Player freeze.
Freeze it there.
Once again, keep his opponent away from her cards. Okay, this is our fourth and final question in this game now. Someone must win the game on the next play of the cards. Control is extremely important. Good luck to the two of you. Sudden death time. To you, Tony. More and more women have taken up pumping iron to build up their muscles. So, we surveyed 100 bachelors, and we asked them, do you find muscles on a woman sexy? How many bachelors said muscles on a woman are sexy?
Low number, I feel. A low number, 24.
24 out of 100, you think?
Yeah.
Kind of gross, isn't it?
I can't, don't like it myself.
All right, Daryl, higher or lower than 24?
Well, I'd have to say it's a little higher, because, I mean, flab isn't sexy either, so I'd rather have muscles.
You're right.
A little higher.
The actual number of bachelors who said muscles on a woman are sexy is 38, yes. It was higher. All right, now, Daryl. Daryl, you've got a decision to make. You have control. You can change your base card of 8, all right, and play through to the end. But if you make a mistake, then Tony wins the game. Or you can pass it on to Tony and force him to call the cards off of his 6. If he goofs, then you win the game. You want to play or pass?
I'm going to pass. It's been good for me.
The last couple of days you passed and it worked. All right, Tony, you've got to play off the 6.
Okay. I'm going to say higher.
Higher than the 6.
Higher.
Sudden death time. The card is higher than the 6. Yes. And now what do you want to do? Higher or lower?
Higher.
Higher. If it's higher, if it's higher than the 8, Tony, you win the game.
Higher.
And the match is tied up. If it's lower, Daryl remains our champion. He'll play the big money cards. The card is an ace. Yes. It is higher. All right. Congratulations to you. One game for Daryl, one game for Tony. We'll pause with these words. We'll be back to play our tiebreaker game, and then we'll see who plays the big money cards on Card Star. And welcome back to Card Sharks. Well, our champion Daryl's won one game, and our challenger Tony one game. You've each got $100, and now it's time to play our tiebreaker game. The winner of the tiebreaker game goes on to play the big money cards. In the tiebreaker game, Susanna's going to start dealing cards over there. She'll deal out only 3 cards, and we'll have a maximum of 3 questions. So good luck to both of you. Serious time. Here we go. High-low question, Daryl, it's for you. We surveyed 100 psychiatrists, and we asked them, generally speaking, do you think Dear Abby gives good advice? How many psychiatrists said she does?
I think basically anybody thinks that Dear Abby gives good advice. Whether anybody follows it or not is another question. So I think the number's got to be pretty high. I'd say 76.
76 out of 100. All right. Tony, do you think the actual number would be higher or lower than that? Psychiatrists who say that Dear Abby gives good advice.
I think it's going to be lower. It's going to be lower than that.
Lower than 76. Let's find out. The actual number of psychiatrists who think Dear Abby gives good advice is 86. It was not lower. It was higher. And our champion has control of our tiebreaker game. Here we go now. This is your base card. It's a 10. Player change.
I'm going to change that card.
Change that card.
Please be good.
Your 10 now becomes a
deuce. Oh, good.
Oh,
okay.
Good decision.
Higher.
Higher than the deuce. Here we go. It's a jack. Freeze or play on?
No, I'm going to play on.
You're going to play on?
I'm going to play on. I think it's lower.
Lower than the jack. If it's lower than the jack, you become our champion. You'll play the big money cards. If not, Tony gets a free shot at his cards. It's a 3, yes! And our champion remains champion. All right. Woo! More money for the baby indeed. Tony, you're a great contestant. Thank you very much. You end up with $100. We have some nice prizes for you.
Great.
Thank you very much for being with us on Card Sharks. Bye-bye, Tony.
Bye.
And Daryl, come here. Boy, I tell you, you are a nail biter. You know that. My good. Everything okay down there?
Everything's fine.
Just hang on. Don't get too excited. Whatever you do, promise me you won't do that. Okay, now you've won the championship, and now we're going to play the big money cards. The first day you went to the big money cards, you won a little over $5,000. The second day had a little bad luck, you remember. But let's play those money cards right now. And here's Lacey and Susanna with a brand new deck of cards that you cut before we went on the air. All right. Here's now how we play our money cards. The $200 that you won just now winning the match is yours to keep no matter what happens. But now we're going to give you some new money to bet with. We'll start you on the bottom line right there with $200. Now, Daryl, you must bet your way across the board by calling high and low. When you get to the second line, we'll add $400 of betting money, and then you bet your way across that line. Remember, minimum bets are $50, except for the final top card, where you must bet at least half of your dollars. And the fun part here is you have three opportunities to change any card you don't like by selecting one of those three spare cards that Lacey is dealing out right now. So you understand all the rules?
Yep.
Good luck to you. I'd like to see you win a lot of money. Will you do that for me? Okay, let's give the lady $200. Here we go. That $200 could turn into $32,000 if you play your cards right. And here's your first card. The card is an ace.
All of it lower.
You're going to go all of it lower.
All
if it's
of
another
it lower.
Ace, if it turns out to be another ace, it's a push when we play the money cards. No win, no lose. All right. It's a five.
Okay.
You've got $400. You can play a change.
100 higher.
You're going to go 100 higher 100 than the
higher.
Five. The card's a nine.
Oh, good. Okay.
You're $500.
Change that card with number two.
He wants to change the nine. The nine now becomes a queen.
Queen, okay. 300 lower.
300, that is lower than the queen. The card is a six.
Oh,
yes.
Good.
All right, you've got $800. We'll go to our second level. We'll give you another 400.
Change that card.
That gives you $1,200.
Okay.
This six becomes your base. You want to change it.
The third card.
Okay. Card number three.
Okay.
The six is now a three.
Oh, good, good, good.
$1,200.
Okay, 1,000 higher.
1,000, that it's higher than the three. No,
oh,
it's not higher than the three. That's a push.
1,000
okay.
higher.
1,000 higher again. No win, no lose there. 1,000 higher, higher than the three. Five.
Okay.
$2,200. Clear change.
I'm gonna keep going, and we'll go 1,500 higher.
$1,500 higher than the five. Yeah!
Yes!
All right, look what you got, the ace. You're at
$3,700.
Here we go. For $7,400, of course. Yes, that's what you win. You are doing well. We'll be back in just a moment to be the new challenger with our champion right after this. Don't go away. See you in a minute. Welcome back to Card Sharks, our champion. Daryl, you won $13,200. Gather yourself up because it's time to meet a new challenger right now. Come in here, Jim. Hello, Jim. How are you?
Hi, Bob. It's good to see you.
Thank you.
I'm a Los Angeles County Ocean Lifeguard.
And, you're a lifeguard?
Yes, sir. I'm the man in the shack that tells you to stay out of the water when it's not safe.
You don't have to tell me. I can't swim, man.
Good enough.
I just walk around and look at the people on
well,
the beach.
Well, yeah, I understand, yeah.
Scared myself to death right there. All right, ready to play this game. Jim, you cut the cards right backstage,
yes, sir.
Right?
Yes, I
all right,
did.
Fine. Then Susanna's going to deal out cards from a brand new deck, and we're going to start this match between you and this very tough lady sitting next to you.
Good.
She's a good champion. All right, here we go with our first high-low question in our match between Daryl and Jim. And, Daryl, the question is for you. We surveyed 100 single women, and we asked them, have you ever been in love with a man who didn't love you back?
Oh,
it's sad. How many women said that they have?
Oh, of course, lots of them. I think
really?
It's got to, I mean, love is a... Well, it's just a tough thing to
go through.
Girls
always have control, though.
Yeah, but guess what? You still fall in love. You still give your heart. I think it's got to be a real high number. I'd say 79.
79 out of 100 women say they've been in love with a man who didn't love them back.
Yeah.
Jim, do you think the actual number would be higher or lower than 79?
I'm going to tell you, Bob, it's not a problem I've had with women.
Do you have any problems with women?
Well, yeah, but not them falling in love with me.
Oh.
I mean... I'll be honest with you. I think it's
we'll see if we can't get you fixed up later,
personal
okay?
Personal experience.
Higher
I'm
going
to say
Jim.
Lower.
You're going to say lower
yes,
than
sir.
That? Well, the actual number of single women who have been in love with a man who didn't love them back is 62. You're right, Jim. It was lower. Okay, Jim, you get the shot at the cards, and here's your base card. It is a six. Change that card if you want to.
I'd like to change that, please.
Want to change it? All right.
Yes, sir.
Here it is. The six now becomes a five. You got to play now.
Let's try higher, please.
Gonna go higher
yes,
than the five.
Sir.
The card is a seven. You can play
I think
for free.
That's a good place to stop.
Freeze right there. Keep Daryl away from those cards because she's dangerous when she gets near him. I'll tell you that. Hey, we have to pause. We'll be back with Card Sharks right after this. Don't go away. See you in just a moment. Hey, that's all the time we have for today. I'm Bob Eubanks, Lacey Pemberton, Susanna Williams, Gene Wood, and the whole gang here saying we'll pick this match up tomorrow. See you then on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
Some of our departing contestants will receive Capture Your Best Memories with a Polaroid. The Sun 600 comes with carrying case and coupon for free film. And a calculator in Vaseline Lip Therapy covers lips better than a waxy stick. It creates a moisture barrier that goes beyond relief to prevention. And a cookbook and new improved shake and bake coating mix for chicken. A special blend of seasonings makes it an even better recipe for crispier, crunchier chicken. And a watch and Isodet spray and lozenges with benzocaine. Fast relief from sore throat pain. Sore throat? Try Isodet. Use as directed. And a member of our studio audience will receive Burt Blinds Wall Away Recliner combines luxurious comfort with traditional styling. Space-saving recliners can be put 3 inches from the wall and still glide to a fully reclined position from Burt Blinds. And one of our polling groups will receive Gibson's Food Freezer with full-width shelves. Glide-out basket, adjustable cold control, and frost-clear system. No frost on containers, packages, or freezer walls. This is Gene Wood speaking for Card Sharks. I'm Mark Goodson, Television Productions.